Hey guys, it's Rachel and welcome back to my channel. Today is December 2nd, 2021. Can you believe it? We're almost at the end of the year. It is freezing cold here right now and I'm currently located at Langara College. I thought it would be a cool idea to take you around the campus as it is somewhat related to the topic of this video. But I don't know if I can go inside because I think you need a fob to get in. But in any case, I will just show you what's at least around the campus. So this is what the front of the school looks like. That, I believe, is the new building. And if you're hearing car noises in the background, that's because Langara is right across a main road where a lot of buses and cars pass by, making the school easily accessible. The eagle is in the nest. I repeat, the eagle is in the nest. Anyway, I hope you enjoy the mini campus tour here at Langara College. Now I'm going to sit down and talk about why I chose to study in Canada and why you should do it in the coming year. So let me do you guys a favor and give you that extra nudge as to why you should study in Canada. Maybe this is a sign that you've been looking for all along. And with that, I'll give you three reasons why you should consider it. Number one. Studying in Canada provides more pathways to becoming a permanent resident. For example, the Express Entry is the largest Canadian immigration program that selects applicants for PR. It is projected that IRCC will invite over 110,000 applicants under this program, and it's only bound to increase for the next couple of years. I actually made a video on Express Entry, so if you want to know more about it, you can watch it here. But as a brief overview, there are three categories under the Express Entry program. First is CEC, or the Canadian Experience Class, which is by far IRCC's favorite program for 2021 that selects applicants or skilled workers that have Canadian work experience. Second, we have the Federal Skilled Workers Program that selects skilled workers that have foreign work experience. And lastly, there's the Federal Skilled Trades, and this is for people that want to become PR based on being qualified in a skilled trade such as construction, agriculture, and even culinary arts. Now, most applicants that don't have any Canadian education or Canadian skilled work experience are limited to either the FSW or FST program. But there hasn't been an FST or FSW draw in a long time. In fact, the last FSW draw was on December 23rd, 2020, whereas the last FST draw happened on August 6, 2020. This is an indication of where IRCC's priorities lie. Now, the good news is international students that have graduated from a Canadian school and have skilled work experience in Canada may qualify for the CEC and the FSW category. Qualifying for two out of the three categories gives you more chances of being selected for PR as opposed to other applicants that only qualify for one. Digging deeper to this point, I want to show you how your education translates to maximizing your score for the Express Entry program. As seen on your screen, you can get 15 points for studying a 1 or 2 year post-secondary program in Canada, and bump that score up to 30 points if you study a program of 3 years or longer. Guys, 15 or 30 points are hard to come by. For example, to get this score, you may need to retake your IELTS exam, pay a couple hundred dollars to move up the next CLB level, or you may have to find a skilled job and work there for at least 1 year. So the fact that IRCC is providing that benefit to us shows preference to international students. Aside from Express Entry, PNP is also another program that you can apply to for PR. PNP, or the Provincial Nominee Program, are for those that have high demand skills and experience to contribute to the economy of a specific Canadian province or territory. There's the BC PNP Program, the Alberta Immigrant Nominee Program, and the ever so notorious Atlantic Immigration Program, to name a few. Now, most provinces require some sort of connection such as education or work experience to qualify, and international students usually have both. So it's like hitting two birds with one stone. And just to drive my point home and kind of put things into perspective, as of posting this video, since the beginning of 2021, Canada has made 40 draws under the Express Entry Program. Of the 40, 17 draws were for CEC applicants, and 23 draws are for PNP applicants. Moreover, from those 40 draws, over 99,000 were CEC applicants, and over 12,000 were PNP applicants. If we're looking at things in percentages, 89% were CEC applicants, and the remaining 11% were PNP applicants. I know there's a lot of numbers here, but we gotta get technical to drive this point home. If you haven't noticed already, there were no FSW and FSD draws this year. Like, nada. But my main point here is, we can clearly see that Canada is quite selective, and they're targeting people with Canadian work experience. And a good chunk of them are international students. By the way, guys, before moving to my next point, if you are finding value in this video and you would like to see more content related to studying and immigrating to Canada, then be sure to subscribe to my channel, RR Denzel, and also comment down below. Okay, reason number two, studying in Canada opens opportunities for you to work here as well. Yeah. As a student, you're eligible to work 20 hours per week off campus and work unlimited hours per week on campus and scheduled academic breaks. I mean, that's exactly what I did. I worked strictly 20 hours per week for my part-time job so I can have enough allowance for my day-to-day expenses. And I cranked it up on term breaks just so I could save more for the long run. My work experience as a student definitely helped me land a full-time job after graduation, which leads me to my next benefit, and that is when you graduate from a PGWP eligible program, you may work in Canada on a post-grad work permit for up to 3 years. Take note though, to get the maximum length for your PGWP, however, you need to take a program of at least 2 years. But guys, imagine being given an open work permit that allows you to work for any employer across Canada for 3 years. That's insane, because there's only a select few that can qualify for an open work permit, and international students fall under that category. But wait, there's more. Aside from the PGWP, your partner or spouse can also benefit from you studying in Canada. And that's because they can come with you to Canada on an open work permit as well. And that's good news for you because, one, you and your partner can be together in a new country. I mean, how romantic is that? Two, you and your partner can work together to pay for living expenses, which is easier to do than on your own. And if your partner found a skilled job during this time, they may even qualify for Express Entry before you do. In short, there's a domino effect of benefits rooted in your decision to study in Canada. Okay, I gotta change angles because this view might be getting a little boring for you, eh? Let's see. Let's see if I could teleport. Did it work? Last but not least, studying in Canada offers opportunities for growth, and I can definitely vouch for that. Oh man, like, you learn so much being here. And let me give you a visual of what that looks like. Let's say, as cheesy as it sounds, I was a caterpillar. It's a terrible, terrible example. And the Philippines was my cocoon. On one end, the Philippines felt like a place where I was well taken care of. On the flip side, it also kind of hindered me to explore things that I wasn't familiar with. Eventually, I knew I had to take my chance, spread my wings by going to a place out of my comfort zone. It was scary, but necessary, at least for me. But don't get me wrong, I didn't come to Canada with the intention to forget who I was, but to build on who I am and what I wanted to be. And as a result, I was exposed to different cultures and people from all walks of life. I became more resilient. I mean, I didn't think that I'd be brave enough to leave the people I care about the most, nor did I expect to come out of my introverted shell and build new relationships here. I earned XP points in doing mundane things like commuting, doing the laundry, cooking, cleaning, handling finances, and adjusting to the seasons. And apparently my English has improved exponentially, which I only started noticing when you guys pointed it out, lol. Studying here definitely expanded my view of the world. It helped me find joy in the little things and gave me a snapshot of my life's purpose. Being in Canada didn't just give me valuable experiences, but also invaluable lessons that will last me a lifetime. And I know that it can do the same for you. But yeah, I hope that this video helped you see why studying in Canada is something that you should consider, both from a technical to an inspirational standpoint. Sure, pursuing studies here can be daunting, but it's one of the most fulfilling things that you can ever go through. But guys, 2022 is literally just around the corner. So if you're serious about studying in Canada, now is the time to do so. That's all I have for today. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. As always, be safe and be kind. And I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.